So hello, we failed miserably at the early entry. Yeah, we didn't make it, but all is okay because we are eating for breakfast fudge cake from yesterday at Cheesecake Factory. Jenny's already tucking into hers. Daddy. What do you think?
Gorgeous. So nice.
Such a good cake. And also really good news, hard drive. Yes, got the hard drive set up, running, it's working. It's currently backing up the GoPro footage. So all is good. Yeah. So yeah, just gonna have a little bit of cake for breakfast. Not gonna manage all of this.
Nope.
But look at it. Yeah. Look at the size of it, like that's my hand in comparison. It's ginormous. And it did look much prettier than this. It kind of got stuck to the container, but oh, it doesn't matter how it looks, it's how it tastes. Here we go again. First stop is gonna be Rip Ride Rocket, and we're gonna do the hidden playlist. So we're gonna have a quick sit down, work out what song that we wanna play, and yeah, see if the hidden playlist is a actual real thing. We'll let you guys know. Here we go. Just done Rip Ride Rocket. The secret playlist is a thing. It does work. So to get the secret playlist up, you have to press and hold, so it's important that you hold the Rip Ride Rocket logo down. So you'll notice on the screen when you first get on, you've got the Rip Ride Rocket logo at the top, then you've got your different categories. Completely ignore the categories, just press and hold the Rip Ride Rocket logo for at least 10 seconds, then a keypad will come up, so almost like a telephone keypad. You have to know the number of the track that you want to play. There's no list, there's no way of scrolling. You have to literally type in a 3-digit code for the secret song that you want to play. So I'll leave a link down in the description to a list of all the songs available. I done Ryan Adams' Run To You, and it worked. I don't know what song Jenny done, but I'm assuming it was a different one. We didn't say what songs we were gonna do beforehand. But yeah, Jenny was trying to press the logo. It doesn't work if you just press it. You have to press and hold the logo. And yeah, you have to do your research beforehand and know exactly what song. Otherwise, you'll be typing a 3-digit code in and it might not work. You will know that the code has been recognized and it's been accepted if you get a, essentially like an error message will come up to say that there's no video available for this song. If that happens, it works. It's been accepted. So yeah, put your 3-digit code in, press enter, that error message comes up, you're good to go. I don't know what the wait times are like today, but Rip Ride Rocket was like 5 minutes, so it does seem quite busy in the parks today, but we'll see. And we can head across the islands if need be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where you from?
So, Shrek, Fiona and Donkey are out doing meet and greets. So Bumblebee is out. Yeah. There we go.
Let's sing it!
Just have a good time.
Here we go.
Can we
Transformers because it's saying it's 30 minute wait, and things like Mummy is 10 minutes. So we bailed, went on Mummy, had a really good time. Now we're gonna go and give Fast and Furious a go for the first time this trip. Sorry if the audio is not very good. I've lost my little like wind muffler for the top of the camera and the microphone. Hopefully it's back at the hotel, but yeah, the camera's without his little hairdo today. It's had a bit of a grade one all over. Meow. Just been on Men in Black. Showed Jenny like how to get higher points, and it was just literally us two on the car. We only went and got the suit. We're Galaxy Defenders.
Yes, we are.
Love Men in Black. Absolutely love it.
Great ride.
When the unofficial Universal Orlando podcast guys are coming out, I think we're having a session on there, and yeah, see who can get the highest points. I don't know exactly what targets are the highest scoring ones, but generally, yeah. If I'm on there with a load of adults that know what they're doing, then got a good chance of getting the suit. So hopefully I'll be in a good chance of being up there. I don't think I'll be top. I think people within the group will know exactly what targets to aim for.
We'll
but
see, that's good.
We will see. So yeah, looking forward to that. So it's about 1 o'clock, so we are now heading to the Simpsons area to get some lunch, maybe a crusty burger or something like that.
And a new basketball.
Yeah, this is one ride that I do not enjoy doing Simpsons, so not doing that. Every time I come off of it, I'm just like, why did I just do that? Why did I just waste 10-15 minutes of my life on a ride that is just horrendous? Makes me feel so poorly. Oh. So no, let's go get a crusty burger.
Food,
glorious food. Okay, let's go in via Moe's. Although it's looking very busy. What are we all queuing for? The bar, by looks of it. Right, photo of Barney.
Get out of my bar, you
outstanding. So I've decided to come outside to get a Bumblebee Man's tacos. Let's see what's on the menu. I think I'm gonna go eat chicken taco. So I went for the chicken tacos. Looks like Jenny is going for a crusty burger. Strangely, the annual pass discount doesn't work on the tacos. That's like the first time ever in the park that, yeah, I've been told that it's not discounted. Like even Starbucks, you get the annual pass discount, but hey ho, but yeah, it looks good. So we're refueled, cooled down,
yes.
And we are now heading over to ET. So ET is like a 10-15 minute wait, I think, at the moment. And there's also two photo ops in the shop. So you can go on ET's bike where he sits in the basket at the front. And then the other one is ET in the closet. You don't need to go on the ride for those photo ops. So yeah, if you haven't got time to do the ride, but you've got like a photo pass, or you just want to get like a one-off photo with ET, then head straight into the shop and you can do them.
Are you going to do
child's time? Got the ET passport.
Thank you.
Transformers did go down. Let's see what the wait time is. 5 minutes. Okay, let's go do it. Woohoo!
So the fate of the Earth is in your hands. Take the off park to safety. Optimus out.
Oh, crushing it, I can feel it. Ugh. Yeah! We've just left studios and we're currently heading across to Islands of Adventure to have a wander around, maybe go on a few rides, see what photo opportunities there are. But first, we are making a stop at Toothsomes. Here we go. So this side is a shop. Through there is the restaurant. And this side is where you get your milkshakes from. All the different types of chocolate you can get. So white chocolate. We have milk chocolate. And we have dark chocolate. Oh, look at the macaroons. Look at them. Wow, got candy floss, all different flavors of candy floss. You've got like sour watermelon, root beer, banana split, that looks quite cool, different colors. Peanut butter and jelly, hot chocolate candy floss, strawberry chocolate, so many different flavors. Caramel apple, and then bulk candy. Finished at Toothsomes. Almost tripped up then and I mixed up my words. That wasn't going too well, was it? So just finished at Toothsomes. I couldn't finish all of mine, so I've brought like the brookie with me. So I'm just literally collecting like really unhealthy food in the fridge at the moment. So yeah, take this back, stick it in the fridge along with the chocolate fudge cake from last night. Our fridge has got quite a few calories in it at the moment. Oh, and the pasta and your teriyaki chicken. There's a lot of food stacking up in this fridge. Since we last spoke, we have done quite a few rides. We've done Spider-Man, we have done Dr. Doom's, and we've literally just gone and done the front row of the Hulk. Front row is amazing. It's absolutely amazing. The launch through that tunnel, you come straight out, straight into this cobra swirl here. Amazing. And it's really refreshing when you go through the like the misty tunnel that goes underneath the walkway. It's like really refreshing because you get covered in like the mist. Oh, it's so good. It's such a good ride, like front row. Not been much of a wait because they got rid of the front row line, so it's not until you get to the front that you can then either go in any row or you join a separate line to wait for the front row. But I don't think many people know about it, or maybe not bothered about it, I don't know. But it's not been that long having to wait for the front row, probably an extra one cart, maybe two carts before you can get on. So definitely worth the wait for the front row. So I think we're just going to carry on having a wander around islands. I think studios is now closed, and yeah, see what we can get on. We're on about going to do the Starflyer later, so we're going to go down to Point on iDrive, which is where the Starflyer is, meeting up with Colin, and he suggested going to like a new burger bar that's there, so we're going to go give that a go. Dr. Doom's going. yeah, so we're going to go give that a go, and then whilst we're there, Jenny and I are going to pop on the Starflyer, trying to persuade Colin to do it, but he's not having any of it. It's not as hot today, but we are still going on River Adventure, just because we're passing by. We've just come past Hagrid's, and it's saying ride full. The ride is still running. Can only assume that is now at full capacity until park closing. That's crazy. Never seen that before. Never seen a ride say ride full. We got a little bit wet on Jurassic Park, just a little bit, but I probably got wetter before the drop. I was just a million miles away in my own little world, and then like sort of the dinosaurs that kind of blow the water up in the air, like the wind direction was the right direction, it just come brought it all over, and I was like, I was soaked twice. And then yeah, the big drop come, we're on second row, so we weren't too bad, didn't get too wet, but I love Jurassic Park. But I do have to say that the gates have stopped opening, so they just stay open all the time now, which just isn't the same.
It just spoils the magic.
You don't get the goosebumps that you used to get when you used to, like when it used to say, welcome to Jurassic Park, and like the gates used to open, it used to play the Jurassic Park music.
Yeah.
That still happens, but it makes such a difference with the gates. They don't open and it doesn't work. It doesn't work. So as for another day, goodbye Universal. Goodbye Islands. And we're back. It's so nice to come back to like a clean, tidy room where like room service has been in. Made the room.
Yeah.
We don't have thousands of rooms.
That's right. That's right.
Sorry.
That's
fine. Alright, anything for you, sir?
Look how many fries Colin's got. Wow. So we've just had a really good meal in Hopdoddy. So essentially they specialise in burgers. Colin has the biggest bowl of chips that I've ever seen. He was an absolute trooper though, and got through them all.
Yeah.
Yeah. But no, it was really good, really good. I just went for the classic burger, which was like a Angus beef burger, added on cheese and bacon, and then had, you can choose like your type of fries that you want. So either standard, I had sweet potato. I think the ones that Colin got were like truffle fries. But yeah, it was really good. Really good. Happily go there again. Later on in this trip, I'm staying at the Avanti, which isn't too far away from Point. So yeah, I can see myself going back there again. It was really good. Really good service as well. Yeah. Now we are heading up to the Starflyer. Yeah, Jenny and I are gonna go on. So, it is really good. It is really good. I've never actually explored iDrive on foot. This is pretty cool.
I think it's
wow. That is cool. Even the pictures are upside down. So we have arrived at the Starflyer. How are you feeling, Jenny?
Good.
Yeah?
Good.
Okay. Oh, you're ready! Gladiators, are you ready?
Ready!
So you're not up there very long?
No.
Long enough for me.
Yeah. Right, should we go get our tickets?
Yes, let's do that.
Right. So we've literally just purchased our ticket, and then Colin, he's been saying about how the bolts don't look very big, and then he was like, look, these are the bolts. They're not very big, and bolts can fail. Final words of confidence. We've got a ticket, we've paid to go on twice, so let's go do it.
I mean, what are these people doing going up this high? Crazy people.
GoPro failed, got it working just in time for the second one as we were going up, so she's done it twice.
Just hey, bad.
Did it? You could have done that, Colin, you could have. You could have.
Not as bad as it looks.
There you go.
It looks just as bad as it is.
Oh,